Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create this ancient iron Viking image. I provided two Photoshop documents for you to download so you can follow along. Their links are located in the video's description or project files. In addition, I provided the link to the font we'll be using, which is called Cabaletta. The first document includes a metal background and a Viking ornamental border. The second document includes images that we'll use to create a shield. It includes the same metal background and an ornamental line. Open the first document and go to Filter and Lens Correction. The Lens Correction utility will open. Click the Custom tab and slide the vignette amount all the way to the left. This created a soft dark vignette along the edges of the metal background, which brings the attention to the center of the image. As I toggle back and forth, you can see the difference. Click the eyeball next to the border to make the border visible, and then click on the thumbnail to make it active. Open your magic wand tool. Make the tolerance 50, check anti-alias, and make sure contiguous is unchecked. Click anywhere on the white area, and then press the delete key on your keyboard to delete it. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Reduce the fill to 0, and double-click on the thumbnail of the border to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is smooth, the depth is 100%, the direction is up, and the size is 5 pixels. Uncheck Global Light. Make the angle minus 90 degrees, and the altitude 30 degrees. The highlight mode is screen, and its opacity is 30%. The shadow mode is multiply, and its opacity is 50%. Then click OK. Open the shield document. Make the metal plate active, and go to Filter, Distort, and Polar Coordinates. Choose Rectangular to Polar, and click OK. Make the border visible and active. If you look closely, you'll notice that this is the same ornamental design as the rectangular border. However, it's squeezed in like an accordion. This is because once we apply the polar coordinate filter, the design will pull back out to its original shape. Click on the white area with your magic wand tool, press the delete key, and then deselect it. Press Ctrl or Command F to repeat the last filter, which was polar coordinates. To enlarge it, press Ctrl or Command T to open your transform tool. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift and Alt on Windows, or Shift and Option on a Mac, and drag it out until it's near the perimeter of the shield. Then, press Enter or Return to accept it. Reduce the fill to 0, and double-click on the thumbnail of the border to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is smooth, and the depth is 100%. The direction is down, and the size is 5 pixels. Uncheck Global Light. Make the angle 90 degrees, and the altitude 5 degrees. The highlight mode is soft light, and its opacity is 75%. Make the shadow opacity 40%, then click OK. Next, we need to cut it out from its background. To do this, open your elliptical marquee tool, go to the top left corner, and press and hold Shift as you drag a circular selection to the lower right corner. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the shield to its own layer. Press V to open your Move tool, and drag the shield to the tab of your first document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold Shift as you drag it down onto the image and release. To reduce its size, open your Transform tool, go to a corner, and press and hold Shift and Alt or Shift and Option as you drag it in to approximately this size. Then press Enter or Return to accept it. Double-click on the thumbnail of the shield to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is outer bevel. The technique is chisel hard. The depth is 100%. The direction is up, and the size is 18 pixels. Uncheck global light. Make the angle minus 90 degrees and the altitude 50 degrees. The highlight mode is color dodge, and its opacity is 50%. Make the shadow opacity 50% as well. Check contour and click pattern overlay. Make the blend mode overlay and the opacity 50%. Open the pattern preset thumbnails and click the gear icon to open your list of pattern presets. Click Rock Patterns. Click OK to replace the current patterns with the rock patterns. Click the second one on the bottom row and click OK. We're ready to add the text. Open your horizontal type tool and choose an ancient looking font. As I mentioned earlier, you can find the link to Cabaletta in the video's description or project files. For this example, I'll choose a point size of 285. For your text, make the point size large enough so your line of text fits well over the shield. Choose Sharp and Center Alignment. The color is irrelevant since the text will be filled with the same texture preset we used for the shield. Go to the center and type out your text. To make sure it's centered on your document, click the Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it. Click the FX icon and choose Pattern Overlay. Open the thumbnails and click the same one as you did before. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel. The technique is chisel hard. The depth is 140%. The direction is up. And the size is 250 pixels. Uncheck global light. Make the angle minus 117 degrees and the altitude 42 degrees. The highlight mode is soft light. Click the color box and type in FFD387. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Make its opacity 100%. The shadow opacity is 75% and check contour. Click Inner Shadow. The blend mode is Multiply. The opacity is 75%. The distance is 0 and the size is 10 pixels. Click Drop Shadow and make the opacity 50%. Uncheck Global Light and make the angle minus 110 degrees. The distance is 30 pixels and the size is 15 pixels. Then click OK. I'd like to intensify the shadow effect by adding another shadow at a different angle. Make a copy of the text layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J, and then hide all the effects in the copy except Drop Shadow. Then reduce the fill to 0. Double-click on Drop Shadow to open it in its layer style window. Change the angle to minus 155 degrees, then click OK. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.